So India consumes $800 billion of food, which are largely derived from agricultural products. This will become 1.1 trillion in the next 5 to 6 years. If efficiencies from lean supply chains were to be introduced into this supply chain, then a large number of people will benefit. And it's obviously possible to have commercial value as well, because we'll build a very large-scale enterprise. And that's the reason we decided to go into this sector. We deliver grains and staples to about 67,000 outlets every day. We deliver fresh produce to about 5,500 outlets every day. The retailer will place an order this afternoon and expect delivery the next morning. I have already predicted the retailer's demand, and that's where our technology becomes useful and relevant. We capture the data of order patterns and use that to forecast product-wise what the demand will be 48 hours ahead. We capture the market prices through a benchmarkers app, and that is used to set the target price for the farmers. On average, farmers made 13.75% better income when they worked with us than when they worked with the market. The outcome of all of this is that our customers get stable supplies at very high fill rates. Because we don't carry excess inventory, we suffer less losses. Our fresh produce loss is, for example, about 3%. Compared to 14.7% for the industry per se.
When we first came across Waycool back in 2019, it was a company already operating at significant scale and established product market fit. Slightly later than the company's Lightbox had historically invested at that time, but once we dug deeper, we got very excited by the sector. But more than one third of the food we produce gets wasted, and majority of it is in the supply chain. Waycool had a radically different approach to this. Been able to reimagine the supply chain from a supply-led model to a demand-led model.
In the last 18 months, the focus for the company has been to demonstrate that the business is intrinsically profitable. So while we've held our revenue largely flat, we have improved our margins and our earnings dramatically. We have reduced our monthly burn by 75%. The intent is to get to full profitability before the fiscal is closed. The brand story has been very, very encouraging and strong. When Lightbox invested in us 3 years ago, we were doing $500,000 a month of our branded products at best. Today, we're doing about $7 million a month of our branded products. This is about 45% of our revenues today. Fact that fresh produce is also now getting branded. But about $2 million of fresh produce today go in branded form.
And through this time, there have been a couple of changes in the business model, both on the product side as well as on the demand side. Over the last 4 years, Waycool has managed to leverage its strong sourcing capabilities to build brands from the ground up across food categories. These include dals, pulses, dairy, ready-to-cook products, and even fresh fruits. Today, these contribute more than one-third of our top-line revenues. Today, it's on a strong path towards profitability. And over the next few years, we expect this to be a strong candidate to be listed on the public markets. This would prove our original thesis of creating value-accretive businesses in one of the most unorganized sectors of our economy.
We intend to take this business to a 5,000 to 5,500 crore revenue business by FY25-26. And deliver an EBITDA of upwards of 5% and closer to 8% if possible. The growth will be powered by deeper penetration into our current geographies, which is southern India, and in many more stores in each town. We are at about 67,000 stores. We want to take that to about 150 to 175,000 stores. So FY25-26 is when we are targeting our IPO. And that's really when we want to list with the targeted revenues of 5,000 to 5,500 crores. And a significant EBITDA, so that we are able to demonstrate our value during this IPO.